The moon is just sitting there, waiting for us to go back. It has resources, opportunities for science and discovery, and Google's XPRIZE gives companies cash to get up there. Hey guys, it's Trace with your weekly DNews space update, and holy wah, Google XPRIZE. If you're not familiar with the XPRIZE, it's one of the ways Google is incentivizing other companies to literally reach for the stars, or the moon, I guess. The search giant hopes to inspire engineers and entrepreneurs from around the world to develop low-cost methods of robotic space exploration. The winner will be awarded $40 million, but there are other prizes as well. The promise of the XPRIZE is what helped foster Spaceship One, the first manned private spacecraft back in 2004. This week, Google announced 5 finalists who will compete for some other prizes along the way to that $40 million grand prize. They're calling these Milestone Prizes. The finalists are from around the world, but they're also from previously successful spacefaring nations. 2 US companies, one from Japan, Germany, and India, will all compete. From now until September, each company will attempt to outdo the others in 3 areas. 1, land a robot on the moon successfully. That alone, you get a cool $1 million. 2, drive that robot 500 meters on the lunar surface. For that, you get 500K. And 3, the robot must create 2 mooncasts consisting of high quality images and video from the lunar surface. This might seem like low hanging fruit for any lunar mission. I feel like I'd want them to land, drive, and take pictures. No matter what, but the point isn't to break boundaries of exploration, but for non-governments to be on a level playing field to compete, lowering the cost of space travel for everybody in the long run. It's important to note, the teams don't actually have to physically get to the moon and complete the tasks to win the prizes. Yes, the winner of the grand prize has to actually do this stuff, but the milestone awards are about testing and analysis. It's not a space race, it's a battle of ideas. Competitors are going to demonstrate their hardware and software to test which of them can produce the most creative, simplest, affordable solution. From there, an international panel of expert judges will determine the winners and award a milestone prize. It's not even necessary to attempt the grand prize to win these little milestone prizes, and so the companies are already competing on a battlefield of ideas. A company called Astrobotic is hoping to tap the wealthy public for some additional support, promising the ability to ship a package on board their robot. Just think, if scientists could afford it, there would be new lunar experiments launched, maybe even in the next year. Or maybe we could have like a coach bag dropped onto the lunar surface or something. Maybe, guys? Do you have any lunar launch ideas? We would love to hear them, so head down and type in the box down below, my little space monkeys. Go ahead, type. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next Friday with another weekly DNews space update.